Mr. Respected Mr. Mohan Arulavi from Hindu Business Line from Bangalore, and Respected Mr. Sadisan, Respected Mr. Dr. Manjuna, and Mr. Sibajit Podar representing Amway, Respected Ladies and Gentlemen. This direct selling is not known to everybody. I mean, even though it is a reality as far as the business sector is concerned, most of the people are not aware of the implications involved in that. When I told one of my friends that we are organizing a seminar on direct selling, now recently, quite unfortunate we can say, some confusions arose, because this Amway was dragged into this money chain business, which was banned during 1979 Act by Parliament. And in almost all the countries, about 170 countries in the world, this is prevalent. It's going on without any problem. Except in Kerala, in other states of India also, it is going on in a good manner. About, I think about 4.9 million young people especially. India is a country where 35% of the people are young people, especially below the age of 20. So many people, a large number of people, million numbers, especially ladies are using this direct selling business. Of course, majority with Amway, and there are other institutions also doing with this direct selling procedure.
ഡയറക്റ്റ് സെല്ലിങ്ങിനെ പറ്റിയുള്ള ഈ പ്രോഗ്രാം വളരെ കാലികമായി പ്രസക്തിയുള്ള ഒരു ടോപ്പിക്കാണ് എന്നാണ് എൻ്റെ അഭിപ്രായം. സോളാർ കേസും ജോസ് തെറ്റയിലും ഒക്കെ പത്ര മാധ്യമങ്ങൾ കൈയടക്കുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് നമ്മുടെ ദൃശ്യമാധ്യമങ്ങളിലും പ്രിന്റ് മീഡിയയിലും ഒക്കെ നിറഞ്ഞു നിന്ന സംഭവമാണ് ആംവേയെ ചുറ്റിപ്പറ്റിയുള്ള ഒട്ടേറെ വിവാദങ്ങൾ. ഡയറക്റ്റ് സെല്ലിങ്ങിനെ സംബന്ധിച്ച് എൻ്റെ അഭിപ്രായം വ്യക്തിപരമായി പറഞ്ഞാൽ ഗുണവും ദോഷവും ഒരുപോലെയുള്ള ഒരു സംഭവമായിട്ടാണ് ഞാൻ കണക്കാക്കുന്നത്. ഇതിൻ്റെ ഗുണം എന്താണെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ സ്ഥിരോത്സാഹവും കഠിനാധ്വാനവും ചെയ്യാൻ തയ്യാറുള്ള വ്യക്തികൾക്ക് മുതൽമുടക്കില്ലാതെ വലിയ രീതിയിൽ ബിസിനസ് ചെയ്യുവാനും അതിൽ നിന്ന് ലാഭമുണ്ടാക്കുവാനുള്ള ഒരു അവസരം ഡയറക്റ്റ് സെല്ലിംഗ് കമ്പനീസ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഡയറക്റ്റ് സെല്ലിംഗ് മാർക്കറ്റിംഗ് വഴി സാധിക്കുന്നു എന്നുള്ള കാര്യത്തിൽ സംശയമില്ല.
Little disappointed that we have a small audience today, whereas the discussion or the seminar is supposed to be, like what Mr. Ansari said, is supposed to be a hot debate going on this. This is a subject where there have been a lot of misunderstandings. There have been a lot of achievements in this field, and if you take the world over, direct selling is supposed to be one of the largest forms of selling. Almost 35% of the selling that takes place to a consumer takes place through direct selling. Just to give you a little brief on the type of figures that are associated with direct selling in India, I think the last year I think we should have done about 7,000 crores, I guess, and there are around 70 lakh people involved in the employment, directly involved in distribution, and about 35% of these 70 lakh people are actually women. Women who otherwise would not have been able to do any form of business, they are highly involved in this business. So you can imagine the magnitude of this business, and in a state like Kerala, where there has been a lot of unemployment, very few opportunities for people to do business, Amway suddenly came in as a beacon of light and showed the way for people to do business. And when you do business by the direct selling form, Let me tell you, there is a major advantage psychologically and otherwise also. A person's confidence develops. If you sell something to somebody, you have to first equip yourself mentally and intellectually, and also sometimes physically, because the task of selling something to somebody else is probably one of the biggest or the most difficult tasks. Because you can face a lot of disappointments, and if you're really good at selling, you can actually conquer the world. So what really happens, and I've noticed, is that there many of the Amway distributors who in the process of doing such business, they have become wonderful people.
We've been having discussions with a lot of the guests on the dais. I mean, Mr. Ansari, Mr. Aswani, Advocate Satishan, who is probably most qualified to give the keynote address than me, if you ask me, on direct selling. And Dr. Manjanath, who's been a very big role model for the Amway program in the state of Kerala. I'm sure you would like to hear to them also. I keep mine very short, very simple. I don't want to take too much of your time also, because I'm sure you would like to get the entire perspective of these things. Somewhere in 1991 or 1992, in Bangalore, early morning 7:30, a lady rang our doorbell and said, "I am from Amway, do you want to buy our products?" There were various products there which, you know, we sort of... I told him, "Sorry, because you are mistaken. PCMC Act is not meant for controlling direct marketing. You are thoroughly mistaken." Then he asked me, "Will you be able to come over here? We will sit together for some time. We will discuss." I told him, "Okay, I don't mind. Kindly give me 2 hours time on Sunday, preferably. The crime was registered in Calcutta police station at that time, or Ambalavai police station. I went to his cottage. He was waiting for me on Sunday at about, say, by 8:30 or so. I went to his house. Up to 2 o'clock, we had a discussion, open discussion. Whether this alleged offense, what is allegation? You are selling a product. You are purchasing a product from a company's warehouse. You are selling to a consumer, mouth-to-mouth sale, other than the customary sale. Customary sale, you know that what everybody knows. Manufacturer, stockist, then wholesaler, then retailer, then end consumer, channel of distribution. Instead of following that one, they are manufacturing the product, and you know that one SIA, when 1994 the permission was given to Amway by Government of India, even in the permission order it is specified.